All right, check that out. There he is. Spider-Man in the flesh here at the Museum of Science and Industry. And behind me, I have Thor and the Hulk battling it out. Tom Barnes here, Chicago scene at the Museum of Science and Industry down here in Hyde Park, where the Marvel exhibit just opened. It'll be open to the public starting Sunday, open now for members. But they have the first ever Marvel comic, Iron Man suits, Star-Lord, Captain America. I mean, they got everything. Black Panther, all of that happening now. So to get the scoop on it, I'm going to talk to my friend Jeff here to see how you get good tickets and some of the highlights to check out here at the Marvel exhibit at the Museum of Science and Industry for the Chicago scene. Let's go say hi. All right, nothing like getting introduced with Captain America behind you. This is Jeff. How you doing, Jeff?
Good. How are you? Good morning.
Good morning, and welcome back, MSI, right? What do you do for the museum real quick?
I am the Senior Manager of Featured Experiences here at Museum of Science and Industry Chicago.
And you got a giant featured experience here with the Marvel exhibit. Tell me about it.
Yeah, we are reopening with a bang and a pow and a bunch of superheroes. We have Marvel Universe of Superheroes that features over 300 props and artifacts and comics from the Marvel Universe in two galleries.
Yeah, so it's split. Right behind you is the first part where they have, just some amazing artifacts like the first original comic book. Tell me about that real quick.
Yeah, that's actually my favorite artifact. Comic number one from October 1939. It was Timely Comics at the time, but it had Marvel on the cover. So that's really an origin story where it all started. So without that, we wouldn't have the rest of it. So I really appreciate that.
Yeah, then you walk through it a little bit and you see, Black Panther, you see Captain America, The Shield, Spider-Man. I mean, it goes on and on. It's like the greatest hits of all, like the Avengers movies to start off with, right? Like, how did you guys get all the costumes and everything else, the props and all that?
Sure. The exhibit has props and costumes from Marvel Studios and a lot of comics from private lenders. But to your point, it's a great immersion, and you can see stuff from the different franchises, but from the comics to the movies all together.
And you guys just opened right now for members, and the public is allowed to come in here and check this out on Sunday, correct?
Yeah, starting Sunday, March 7th, we'll be reopening for the public 5 days a week, Wednesday through Sunday. And tickets are online in advance because we do have limited capacity time ticket entry for safe COVID guidelines.
Sure, sure. And part of the unique draw, particularly here in Chicago, is that even you have some comics that maybe some people don't know about because they're not in the movies yet, but you even have something with Chicago ties. Tell me about that one real quick.
Yeah, we have a comic for Chicago only, Ironheart number 2, written by Chicagoan E-Viewing, featuring the character Riri Williams. So we're very excited to have that, as well as some other additions for Chicago. The exhibit's always kind of changing when it goes to different cities.
Yeah, so it started off maybe in Seattle and then Detroit at one point, and this is about the fourth stop of this particular journey, right?
Yeah, we are the fourth stop, so we will have the exhibition now through October 24th in Chicago, so it's definitely a must-see.
And you not only have the exhibits here, where you have some interactive things going on, right?
Yeah, we have most of our interactives the way you know and love them. We just give everyone a stylus so they can still be interactive but be safe. And then we also just opened our Pioneer Zephyr today, so that's been reimagined. So that's a great opportunity to see that as well.
And I'm just looking over your shoulder here. You got a little Spider-Man happening over there. I'm going to just take a peek. Is that something that people can expect, or is that just kind of for the opening weekend?
This is just for our opening weekend for members. We thought Spidey should pop in and say hello and welcome them back to the museum.
And for people, again, the website to get the tickets and everything?
Sure. All the information is msichicago.org for getting tickets for Marvel and the General Museum, and also seeing when we add tickets and hours as we kind of roll through the summer.
For people who are just like, how did this happen? How did you guys accumulate this collection? Like, where did it come from? All that good stuff.
So this exhibition was developed by an outside company that worked with Marvel Studios and lenders. And then we were very interested in hosting it because we thought it was such a great opportunity to talk about creativity, ingenuity, and just the Marvel franchise that everyone loves as kind of a gateway to that.
And these are things that are from the movie, right? Like the Captain America shield and the costumes and the Iron Man suits and all that you get to see?
Yeah, there's nearly 20 beautiful costumes. And one of the things I appreciate is you can really see the detail when you're here. For example, Black Panther has 3 different layers of printing, and you can see the Wakanda alphabet if you look up closely at the costume.
Yeah, they're incredible. I mean, you can just kind of walk around. I mean, I know it's a little, I mean, it'll be timed visits and all that good stuff, but the detail is just incredible.
the, and you have more than just one thing, like you have more than one Iron Man, you have more than one Captain Marvel, or even, you know, Star-Lord, Groot from Guardians of the Galaxy. So this stuff is real fun, and people can nerd out.
Yes, no matter what kind of fan you are, whether you're a diehard aficionado or if you're just more a movie fan, there's something for everyone, which is why it's such a great exhibition.
Yeah, I mean, they even go back to the details of the history of Marvel with, like, their horror comics in the 70s and their supernatural comics like Doctor Strange. And you just kind of weave your way through this really well and put together exhibit. It makes it a lot of fun, and it's totally fine for families with little kids. There's nothing scary going on. It's just a whole family affair to get back to the museum, right?
Yeah, exactly what you said. It's such a multi-generational show, whether it's people interested in WandaVision now or people that have been with the comic franchise for the last 60 years or so. So it's great for the whole family. And again, so much stuff in there, no matter what kind of Marvel fan you are, with over 300 props and artifacts and comics.
Yeah, 300 artifacts alone in the comics. I mean, some of these comics are rare and never seen for most people, so this is great. If people want to take pictures and put it up on an Instagram handle, where do you suggest they do that?
We can always use the handle #MSIChicago. The exhibit, as you saw, has tons of photo ops in there, and we do encourage that done in a safe manner, of course. So I think people have a lot of fun sharing this experience on social media now that they're welcomed back at the museum.
And real quick, is there an amount of tickets people can buy at once, or is it just you buy it for your time and then you're with your family or with your group?
Yeah, the tickets for the exhibit are kind of like general admission currently, where you have to select a time in advance, and there's just a certain allotment of inventory every time. So again, check our website and you'll be able to see what's available when you want to come and visit.
All right, Jeff, thanks a lot. I appreciate it. I'm going to go ahead back in and take
a look. Enjoy the exhibit. There's a lot more to soak up.
Yeah, for sure. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I mean, you could probably spend hours here at this exhibit. It's amazing. TBARNAS at WGNTV.com. TBARNAS at WGNTV.com. If you have a suggestion for the Chicago scene, get your tickets now to be able to get in a little bit later on this year, because it's incredible. I'll see you later. Thanks for watching the Chicago scene.